So hi students, so we are discussing our second lesson, that is operation on whole numbers. Okay, so last class up to exercise 2.1 we have completed, exercise 2.1 up to third number we have completed. Okay, so now in fourth number you see exercise 2.1, here what given? Last class we have completed up to number 3. Okay, so number 4 what given? Write true or false. If false, correct the statement. Okay, true false you have to find. First statement what given? If two whole numbers are added, the sum may or may not be a whole number. Okay, if two whole numbers are added, then the sum may or may not be a whole number. So this statement is true or false. This is false, because whenever you add two whole number, then our result is always a what? Whole number. Suppose you are adding 0 and 1, how much you will get? 1. Okay, 1 is also a what? Whole number. 0 is also a whole number. 1 is whole number. Suppose you are adding 5 plus 6. 5 is one whole number, 6 is whole number, and you will get result what? 11. 11 is also a what? Whole number. Like this, always you will get what? Whole number. Okay, so these are here what given? May or may not. Okay, so may or may not, it is always. Next statement what given? 0 is the identity element for addition. Okay, this is true or false? True, because 0 is what? Additive identity means what? If with any number, if you add 0, this number will remain same. Just for example, if you add 0 with 3, 3 plus 0 you will get what? 3 only. 5 plus 0 equal to what? 5. That means 0 is what? Additive identity. If you add 0, the number will remain same. Third number statement what given? Second number how we have to write? True. Okay, this statement is what? True. Third number statement what given? The sum of any two odd number is always even number. This is true or false? True. True statement. That means earlier we got, if you add any two odd number, the sum always you will get what? Always you will get an even number. Okay, so next statement what given? If we change the order in which four numbers are added, the sum changes. No, this is false statement. Because why? Earlier we got which property? Associative property we got. In associative property what we got? Associative property, closure property, commutative property. Okay, in this properties what we got? If we change the order of numbers in a sum, okay, then their sum will not change. Okay, ultimately their result will remain same. Suppose example 2 plus 3 plus 5. Okay, how much you will get? You will get 10. But if you write like this, 5 plus 3 plus 2, if you change their order, you will get what? 10. That means their sum will not change. Okay, so here this one is false statement given. So next fifth number what given? The associative property of addition states that in whatever order we add two whole numbers, the sum always remain same. This property, this is what? Actually commutative property. This one is what? Commutative property. Commutative property is what? If any order, if you add two number, okay, equal to 5 plus 2. In associative property, what we say? If you make group, if you add more than two number, if you add more than two number, associative property you can see again one time in your book. Here, more than two number, if you add three or more number, then we can make them group, okay? So we can make them group in any manner, okay? This doesn't matter which numbers you are making group, okay? This is associative property. So this statement is also what given? False. Next fifth number question is what given? Find the missing digit. Okay, find the missing digit in this addition sums. Okay, here these are addition. Okay, we have to find the missing digits, but one condition given: the digit is the same in each blank for each sum. That means in this sum, first one, in each blank, same digit will come. Okay, here, 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 and each blank, same digit will come. Okay, so this one, how you can find? Okay, for that, you see here, from one will start. Okay, from one trial and error method will use. Okay, so here, if you put one. First in the blank, if you put one here also we have to put one, and here it should become what? One. So let us see here one will become or not. So if you put here 1, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 1, 6. Here 6 will come. They are not same. Next, if you put 2 here in the blank, if you put 2 here also you have to put 2, and here in the blank also it should come 2. So if you add, what will become? 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8. Here, how much will come? 8 will come. So this one will not become. Okay. So next, you see, if you put 3 here, if you put 3, here also we can put 3, but here also it should become what? 3. So let us see. 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 3, 10. So 10 here, 0 will come. So it is not satisfied. So next we will put 4 here. Okay, so 2 plus 4 6 6 plus 2 8 8 plus 4 12. So 12, 2 will come here, so they are not same. Okay, so these are also not satisfied. Next, you see, if you put 5 here, 5, how much it will become? 2 plus 5 7 7 plus 2 9 9 plus 5 14 14. What will come here? 4. So it is also not same here. Next, we'll put 6. If you put here 6, here you will put 6. Let us see here 6 will come or not. 2 plus 6 8 8 plus 2 10 10 plus 6 16. So here 6 coming. Okay, so remaining will check, remaining will match or not. So if by when we put 6, the power first blank is matching. Okay, first, that means in one's place all are, that means matching. So next, in all place we have to put 6, and we have to check whether all the sum will become will satisfy or not. Okay, so next place, you see here 16 16. Okay, 6 we put here and 1 will carry here. Okay, so next 5 plus 7 12 12 12 plus 3 12 plus 3, what? 15. And 15 plus this carry one, 16. Okay, 16 plus 6, 22. 22, 2 is there, again 2 carry. 2 will come here. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 7, 19. 19, 9 is there. 1 again carry here. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 6, 16. This one is 16. Okay. So if you put 6 here, all our sum will satisfy. Okay, so our answer is what? 6. You have to put 6. Okay, so this next question you have to find like this. Okay, you have to try this one. Okay, so next 6 number, you see, in second number also, here what you have to do, you have to put like this. Okay, here if you put, okay, this one homework you mark. This one you have to do by yourself. You have to try. 6 number, you see what given. Write any 2-digit odd numbers and add them. Is the sum odd number or even number? Any 2-digit odd number we have to write. Any 2-digit odd number you write. Solution, how to write? Any 2-digit odd number. Okay, you see here. You write any 2-digit odd number. Okay, any 2-digit odd number you take. Suppose I am taking here 13 and 17. I am taking. Okay, so if you add 13 and 17 17 plus 13, if you add, how much you will get? 7 plus 3 10 10 0 1 will carry. 1 plus 1 plus 1 3. How much you will get? 30. Okay, so 17 plus 13 equal to, you will get 30. So 30 is what number? Even number. 30 is what? Even number, because what? Last digit is 0. Okay, so this one is our even number. That's why what given? That one only we have to say, is the sum odd number or even number? So we have to write our sum is what? Even number. Okay, next, 7 number, you see, write any 2-3 digit even number. Now we have to write any 2-3 digit even number. Any 2-3 digit even number. Okay, so 3 digit even number, you see I am writing here, suppose 344 I am writing. Okay, any number you can write. Okay, and suppose I am writing 558. These two number, what we have to do and find their difference. Their difference we have to find, and we have to see whether their difference is even number or odd number. So their difference you find here, 558 and 344. So 8 minus 4, 4, and 5 minus 4, 1, and 3, 5 minus 3, 2, 214. Okay, so 558 minus 344 equal to what? 214. 214 is what number? Even number. Okay, 214 is even number. So whenever you subtract any two even number, then our result is also a what? Even number. Okay, next you see question number 8. Add each of the following and check the answer by adding them again in a different order. This one you see, if you have to add first like this. Okay, if you add like this, how much you will get? 42,061. Okay, after that 398. After that 4,52,786. If you add, how much you will get? 8 plus 6, 14, 14 plus 1, 15, 15, 5, 1 carry. 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 9, 18, 18 plus 6, 24, 24, 4 will come, 2 carry. Okay, 3 plus 7, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 to 1 carry here. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5, 4 plus 5, 9 and 4. So 4,95,245 we got. Okay, how much we got? 4,95,245 we got. Okay, so these numbers, if you write in different order, that means if you write, see here, this one you can write, after that you see, if you write this number in different order, that means suppose you are writing 4,52,786 plus, suppose after that you are writing this one, 42,061 plus, again after that you are writing 398. Okay, so how much you will get? Same result you will get. Okay, earlier how much you get, that much only you will get. Okay, you have to check you will get same or not. Okay, next, 9 number, you see, next you see 9 number. Find the answer using the most convenient arrangement. These numbers we have to arrange according our choice, and we have to find the answer. First one, you see, first one I am writing here 1207 plus, okay, 301 plus 4,793. These numbers we will arrange according to our choice. Okay, anyway you can arrange them, that means we will make them group. You see here, so these two number we will add. First we will write this one, okay, 4,793 plus, okay, 1,207. plus this one we will write as 301. Okay, now we will add all this. All this by putting in vertical line also you can add. Okay, so if you add them, how much you will get? 3 plus 7, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. 11, 1 will come again. 1 will carry. Okay, is 0. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 and this one is 9. So 9 plus carry 1, 10. Then 0 will come again. 1 carry. Okay, so again 3. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 4, 5 plus 7. 12, 12 plus 1, 13, 3 will come, again 1 will carry, and in this 1, 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, okay, so this much he will get, okay, in different also, by another way also you can arrange, okay, you will get the same result. Tenth number, you see, if there are 28 boys and 29 girls in a group, would you have to arrange for an odd number or even number of shares for the group? Okay, one group is there, you have 28 boys are there. Okay, total number of students were 10 number solution, you see. Tenth number, how many boys are there in the group? In the group. How many boys? 28 boys and how many? 29 girls are there. Okay, so total students, total students equal to what? 28 plus 29. 28 plus 29, how much you will get? 9 plus 8, 17, 7. Okay, and one remaining, and this one is 5. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 57. So how much you got? 57 students. So 57 is what number? Odd number. 57 is what? Odd number. So what would you have to arrange for an odd number or even number of shares? So we have to arrange an odd number of shares. Okay, so in this class, that much only. Okay, thank you.